Hello, everyone. You are welcome to Nebo TV. My name is Nepe Obasoge, broadcasting from Toronto, Canada. We are here today to discuss about Governor Obaseki's developmental strides in Edo State, some of the development created by his administration for 3 years plus. And today I also have in the studio with me, all the way from the UK, Dr. Tony Osakpoma Agbons. Thank you for joining me today, Dr. Agbons.
Thank you, Nekme. Very happy Sunday to you and to all of our viewers all over the world. I bring greetings to you and happy new month to you all also. It's my pleasure to be back here again.
Thank you, thank you. So today we are focusing on the developments created by his administration in Edo State, because we have been discussing about the crisis in Edo State, the political crisis in Edo State over this month. It is time for us to go deep into some of the development, not all, but some, so far, okay, yeah. For 3 years plus. Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
You have the list with you, right?
Yeah, thank you, Nekme. There's a lot of developmental strides that this administration of Governor Godwin Obaseki in the last 3.5 years, quite a lot. And I'm sure we'll not be able to exhaust all of them today. So like you've mentioned, we'll just look at some for our people to hear and see what the governor has done, quite a lot. Now, before I go into mentioning some of these developmental strides, which are littered all over the nook and crannies of Edo State, I just want to say that I personally feel that some of the attributes that have made this possible for the governor to do all this is that he is the governor, as I see him, is a cerebral intellect, very knowledgeable. He's focused, and greatest of all, he's got a very strong love and compassion for the people of Edo State. And you see that very much in him, Nekme.
Yes.
So that is what I have to say as an introductory note.
Thank you. Thank you. Especially the Zoom meeting yesterday.
That was wonderful. Yes. I'm not sure in the history of Nigeria we've had that kind of experience, a governor coming on Zoom to you know, declare his manifesto, the mega manifesto to Edo's all over the world. It was an awesome meeting last night.
Amazing. Yes. Yeah. So let's go into this list which
yes. Yes.
First of all, before you start, we have a video. I'm going to play the video of the development documented by his administration. So I'm going to play the video after the discussion. Okay. Go ahead. The first
yes.
one on the list.
Yes. Yes. Someone on my list here, I have the Ugbo Amagba Road.
Okay.
We have Iriri Awogba Obazagbon Obagie Ogege Road, Obahianto Road, TV Road in Benin City.
Is it construction?
Yes. Yes, these are roads that have been constructed. And I'm sure our people back home, and even those that have visited home from the diaspora, they can visibly see this road. And some of these have even been showcased on social media. See a lot of those sons and daughters posting some of these infrastructural development on social media, because there have been these arguments from people who have been claiming, oh, the governor has not been doing anything. It's just a MOU. But
yes.
Nekwe, I can tell you that these projects, they are verifiable. And I'm sure people who really want to do the right thing can go to these places and see them, and they are there. They
yes.
are very much there.
That's why I'm going to play the video as well.
Yeah, thank you.
Not all of them were documented.
Yes.
In the video, but there are some of them in the video that you're going to watch. It's very interesting.
Yes, so going further, if we go out of Benin City now, we have Agbede, Anwan Road, Central Road in Ekpoma, Emu or Hadwa Bridge. I'm sure this should be in Esako, not very sure, but I think it's in Esako. Then we have this Samuel Gbemudia Stadium, which you have mentioned. This is a stadium that was the pride of all those when some of us were very young. Ogbe Stadium, we used to go there for on Children's Day, May 27, and then when we used to celebrate Independence Day on October 1st.
Yes. So,
yeah, but after a while, because of negligence by some past administration, that stadium became dilapidated. So the whole thing just went down. But His Excellency, this governor, has brought that stadium back to life. And I was watching the flag off of the election campaign recently, and that stadium is looking marvelous. I'm sure, Nekme, you can attest to that as well.
Yes, yes. During the PDP campaign,
So that one is there. Then we have this one. This one is very important, Nekme. The new secretarial buildings.
Secretarial buildings.
Before now, if you go to our secretariat, it was an eyesore.
Yeah.
So, and I used to wonder how civil servants who go there, how they can cope, because the ambience of an environment determines worker output and productivity. So when people work in a serene, comfortable environment, their productivity is higher.
Exactly.
And this is the governor. Yes. And then if you see the new secretarial building now, it's just like what you have in most of these developed countries. And people are wondering, is this in Benin City? Is this in Edo State?
I saw a video where they compare the stadium in the UK with the Samuel Gbemudia Stadium in Benin.
Thank you.
We are moving forward.
Yes, definitely.
With those in the Western countries, which means we are moving forward.
Yes, and to add to it, this the secretarial building, you have the new ICT buildings, because the world is going technological. Like, you are interviewing me now. You are in Toronto, Canada, and I'm in the United Kingdom. So this is the power of technology. Some years ago, this cannot happen. I needed to be with you in the studio, you know, where you are, for us to have this show. So the governor understands the power of ICT, information communication technology, and that building is there so that people can send email. These days, you hardly see, carrying of files all over the place. So gradually, we are doing away with some of these old, archaic practices. And doing modern things that fits with their global best practices. And then I also have the Benin Technical College in Benin City, Judges Quarters. This one has been completed. Edo Hotel, the new Ambrose Ali University Admi building in Ekpoma, Edo Innovation Hub, then the modular refinery. This one is in Isino Logbo in Kubaohan local government.
They said that one is a wonderful project.
It is, and it's 70% completed as we speak, Nekwe. 70, and that refinery will be refining, so they will be refining petroleum in Edo State.
You know how it will create jobs, opportunities.
Absolutely. And for people who are saying MOU this, MOU that, this. The plan and preparation for this modular refinery started in January 2018. And as we speak, it is 70% completed. So people should go to this place. It's not just about mentioning things that are abstract. We are talking of tangible projects that you can feel and see. You understand what I'm saying? So a lot of these projects are going on. I've got so much here, Nekwe. I just finished my first list. So okay. If you want me to go on, I'll go on. And I will highlight more further.
Go ahead.
Yeah. So, and then we have the Osiomo Independent Power Plant. That will capable of generating 55 megawatts of electricity.
Yes, for the education.
The government has said this one, for now, this one will supply power to government buildings and facilities so that there will be no power cut. And following that, the electricity will also be generated for the people of Edo State. So these are monumental projects and vision that are coming out in our state. There is the 1,451 unit Emotan Gardens estate project at Telpa Sakomba Road. The first phase has been completed. So this is how massive this is housing. So the Upper Sekki administration is touching every sector. We already mentioned the Samuel Bemudia Stadium, the sports facilities are going to be in every local 18 local government of the state, every one of them. Even in Benin City now, I saw a clip. Western Boys High School in Benin City, in Ikobahi there's a mini stadium there for sporting activities. We have the Jara Mall at Sakomba Road. This one came to be with a private partnership. The mall, this mall is already operational. And of course, we cannot be talking about this developmental strike without mentioning the Edo Basic Education Transformation.
That one is very popular, and
it's very, this one is very dear to my heart, being an academic myself. Very dear. As some of the system, as some of the things I see in that I do best, are things that are very, very much operational in places like the UK, in the US, in Canada, and some part, and in European countries.
Yes.
So some of these things have been duplicated in Edo State. And roads are being completed in all the 18 local government areas of Edo State. I want to digress a little bit. Because people will be saying, oh, is it just about road? Is it about constructing buildings and all that? There's one project I want to talk about. This one is not like something tangible. It is intangible, but I have to mention it. Law reforms. Local government service in Edo State. I was watching a clip of the governor. He inaugurated the Law Reforms Local Government Service Commission Committee to reform our laws in Edo State.
Okay, dependent state laws.
Thank you.
Yes.
Because Edo State, I think it was during the regime of General Ibrahim Babangida that Edo State was created in 1993, I think. Yeah, I remember. So we are still operating bended state laws. And some of these laws have gone obsolete.
Yes.
And they are no longer relevant to today's life.
Outdated laws.
Outdated, yes. That's the word I was looking for. Completely outdated. So these are reforms. Every sector being touched.
Yes. I think I discussed about that in one of my videos, maybe the biography I did for Governor Obaseki. I discussed about the state laws, that he reformed the laws, that he inaugurated a committee that will look after those laws, they reform those laws because they are not relevant to our modern society anymore.
Yeah. So and okay, let me go to this one. This one is a clincher. Agriculture. I think you mentioned it. You have mentioned this as well. Agriculture. Yes. In Edo State now we have farms in Igoriaki, rice farm there. In Warake, I hope I pronounced that one correctly. We have in Agenebode, Ilushi. There's a soya beans farm in Ekpoma. We have maize farm in Sobe and Usugbeni.
Usugbeni, yeah.
Yes. So all these projects littered everywhere. So when people say it's all about MMU, I just look at them and said, for once, let us be honest with ourselves and give credit where it is due. It's not about politics. We can see these things. These are very visible projects.
We are talking about 3 years plus in office.
Only 3 years, yes. 3 years plus. So you can imagine what will happen in 8 years.
Full year, 8 years. Oh.
I'm sure the governor that's going to succeed Governor Obaseki when he finishes his tenure in 2024, that government is going to have a huge mountain to climb, from what I'm seeing. Because the standard, the bar that this governor has set, that he is setting, it's going to be really high.
He's setting the bar so higher.
Yeah. And it's leaving a legacy, not just for this our generation, but generations to come.
Exactly.
A lot of those sons and daughters, he talk of Samuel, our governor, may still rest in peace, Dr. Samuel Bemudia. People still talk about him. People still talk about Ambrose Ali. And I must tell you, Nekmenda, since the time of Bemudia, the closest we have had is Governor Obaseki.
Yes. That's what I've been saying.
And I'm sure if Bemudia was here today, Bemudia would be smiling and saying, go on, son, go on, son.
Yes.
Yeah, and Bemudia will be happy if Obaseki surpasses his achievement. Because like we say, the glory of the latter is always greater than the former. So there's a lot going on. There's Edo traffic management, a more refined approach, not the harassment we used to have. Not the local one.
Exactly.
ETM, Edo Traffic Management, has provided employment for a lot of our youths.
Exactly. In a professional way. Not those that come and, intimidate people, arrest people in the streets. In a very professional way.
Very professional way. And then you have the security, the operation, the popular operation, Wabai Ziga. I like that coinage. I said, how did they come up with this construction? Beautiful. Why by Ziga?
Yes. The last time I went to Nigeria, they even came to provide security for me. I went somewhere. So I have the picture all over. Okay. Very beautiful. Very beautiful. State. It's a state security agent that provides services for the state. They provide security for the state, like the Amoteku in the Western region, the Western South region, right? So the Amoteku.
Yeah, in the southwest of Nigeria.
Yeah, yes. So the same thing in those states that Governor Obaseki came out with. This is state security. Bagbaziga, yes.
Yeah, Bagbaziga. And then the last one I have on my list here, Nekme. So that you can show the video you say you want to show. He said, do job.
Do job.
And they are testimony. People apply for jobs online, skill acquisition, entrepreneurship. And in this do job, one of the key things they do, so that people need to know these things. People should find out things. You don't just say them say. Go find out things. This do jobs has an online job matching program. So let's say I studied IT, for instance. So you just go there, you type in IT jobs. And you know one thing, Nekwen, this one just came to me now. The governor has been working on internet connectivity in our states. There's been an installation of, 400 kilometers or 4,000 kilometers, I can't remember the exact distance now, of fiber connection going on to increase, because like we said, like we both agreed earlier, the world is going technological. Everything now is mobile.
Yes, digital.
Yeah, digital. Yes. So that one is ongoing.
Yes.
So that people, they're able to connect their internet, get broadband, and do their work.
So I want to quickly use this opportunity to announce this to my followers. So if you are watching right now, on Tuesday, the head of Edo Jobs in Benin City will be joining me here on the studio, okay, to discuss about the Edo Jobs in Benin City, okay? So Tuesday, 2 o'clock in Nigerian time, that will be 9 o'clock in Canada. So she will join me here on Nebo TV live broadcast. If you have your questions, please don't forget to join the show that day so that you can ask your questions. Okay, she will be here with us. Okay, go ahead, Doctor.
So as I was saying, then this one I almost forgot. This one, the Edo Fertilizer and Chemical Company. You see that company, Nekme, has been moribund for 14 years in Edo State. Look, some of us we may be in the diaspora, but we take time to find out what is going on back home. So And this this is producing 60,000 metric tons of fertilizer for our farmers.
For farmers.
So in summary, I just see that.
And the governor also provide mechanized farming in
Edo State. Yes.
You saw that in one of my videos where I documented it, that now instead of people using manual kind of labor whereby you use cutlass, they are using machineries, mechanized farming.
Yes.
So we're in modern era, people are not supposed to be using those old methods of farming anymore in Nigeria. So this governor tried to boost it a little bit for them, providing machineries for them, mechanized farming in Edo State.
Yes. So let me just summarize, Nekma, because I can go on and on talking about these developmental strides. Let me just summarize. What I've seen in the last, since 2016 in Edo State, is that I see a governor building a progressive state. He's strengthening public institutions. He's developing our young people. Like we discussed in a previous program when I came on your show, we have to change the narrative from this gra-gra and agberoism that has been going on. There are factors responsible for this, and those are the things that this government is eliminating or has eliminated.
Mm.
So finally, the last thing I want to talk is internally generated revenue. And this is where the governor has been having pressures and challenges.
That
is causing all the trouble.
Problem, yeah.
This is what I see.
Mm.
I watched a clip of the governor. I think it was on Channels TV and the popular Channels Focus on Politics by Sheun, the Sheun guy.
Yes.
And the governor said, before he came on board, already local government, which fortunately is where the governor comes from, already local. IGRO in Oredo was 5 million. But that's 2016. But as we speak, like in 2020, it's over 100 million. And the reason is simple. Governor, remove non-state actors from collecting these revenues because they will just collect it and put it in their own pockets.
Mm.
And this is where all the troubles they are coming from.
Exactly.
In every civilized climb in a society, it's government that collect revenue and use for the people, revenues and taxes.
Exactly.
So, and if
the government is managing the internal revenue properly, those money can be used to develop the states.
Thank you.
And in time of Adaso Shomole, reverse was the case because he was not managing the internal revenue properly.
Already,
borrowing from outside, of which we can generate internal revenue, it would take the state that we have to develop the state. He was borrowing instead. That's what happened during his
administration. I'm mortgaging the future of our children yet unborn.
Exactly.
Putting the state in debt. So the IGRO of our local government have gone up, and the way we collect revenue now is not very peaceful. Nobody is being harassed. Nobody is being intimidated by agberos and touts and all that. So everything is, you can see that's why the market remains, they're happy. And then Edo is predominantly has been a civil service state, and the government wants to change this. We cannot remain a civil servant state. Everybody, you finish school, you want to get job in a ministry of works. Well, no,
it's not enough.
We need to build our informal sector. These are some of the roadmap. These are some of the foundation that this governor is building. So sometimes I just wonder why are people troubling this government?
Because it's not satisfying them.
Yes.
Because of their self.
So non-state actors. The governor will use that word. Non-state actors. They want to run the show. So what then is the purpose of government? If people, non-state actors, are not the one collecting revenue and just using it for themselves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So these are the things. And in Edo State now, workers, they receive salary as and when due. They don't ask for it. They just get alert.
Yes.
Pensioners. Yes, thank you.
Pensioners, they don't have to go queue up, waiting how many days. every day they go out there. One of my friends came to this show the other day, describing how her mother was a victim of this pensioners, that they don't pay pensioners. They would go in the morning, she would wake up, carry cold water with her, go queue up for hours and hours. At the end of the day, nothing will happen. She would come back again tomorrow, the same thing. Some people died.
Many died.
Not getting nothing.
Let me just give, because I like to give examples so that people can relate with it. I don't like talking in the abstract. Last week, I was talking to a childhood friend. We grew up together in New Benin area. And I was just, I do my survey every time. I update my survey here. And I was like, my sister, how you see this Obaseki matter? I say, Obaneo, which is the very popular slogan we are all saying now. He said, because the dad is retired from a water board of those days. He said, now the dad just get a latch. She was telling me, this lady. Yeah, she said that. So my dad gets a latch at the end of the month, regular. He said, all the areas that they will be owed, this governor cleared it.
Yeah.
For once, let us acknowledge good when we see it. Look, Nekme, I wrote this quotation down. It's from Aristotle. Maybe this will be the last thing I will say, so that you can play that video if I don't have time left. He said, Aristotle said something. He said, there is only one way to avoid criticism. Do nothing, say nothing, and be nothing.
See,
and this capture. He said, there's only one way to avoid criticism: do nothing, say nothing, and be nothing. So it is the work, the good work of the governor, that is causing this anger. But this is unbelievable.
I have the quote here. Maybe I just put it.
Okay.
Scrolling back. Aristo, yes. There's only one way to avoid criticism: do nothing, say nothing, and be nothing.
Yes.
So that people can read it.
Aristotle, the famous Greek philosopher.
Yeah.
I look at the governor. I see that the governor, the governor is not even, he's not even bothered. He's going on with the work he's doing. It's not, the governor is not bothered. He's not. He's going on with it. So the people can keep just ranting around and saying all sorts, but the governor is going on with his work. He's going on with it. And I know many Edo sons and daughters, they are happy. And that is why in this election, like I've said, when I get invited for a talk like this, I always say, we need to use our people power. Yeah, people can resign for what in one of these states in the South South, was it not Cross River? No, Akwa Ibom. Yes, yeah, a lot of people were resigning, but the incumbent governor still won the election. He still won it. So
yes.
Yeah, people can resign, mortgage their conscience and all that for a plate of porridge. But that is not going to deter the majority of Edo people who see this governor as working for them.
Yes.
Not working for a few. I will never stop saying that.
One thing I find very interesting about this governor is the way he captures the minds of many millions of Nigeria beyond only Edo State this time.
Yes. Yes.
That those who are not Edo State citizens are supporting the governor. That just shows that this man is an extraordinary governor. Okay,
yes.
Came for a purpose, to come and change democracy in Nigeria.
Absolutely. So, for me, if maybe people that are close to the governor, they are watching this, it should just take it in the stride. Yeah, this criticism and this pressure that are coming. It's because he's doing something. He's saying something, and he's something.
He's a hero.
Yes, absolutely.
10 years from now,
yeah.
People will be celebrating him, celebrating yeah. his legacy, and yes. in the history of Nigeria, a governor that came to shape democracy in Nigeria. And he will be listed. He will be in the number one list.
Absolutely. We've had some performing governors in some areas. I think in Lagos, they still talk, even though it was military, people still talk of Buba Marwa and all that. Yeah, Latif Jakonde in Lagos those days. So Obaseki is going to even eclipse those ones.
Yes.
So and we all must support him. So I want to plead, Nekwe, I'm just summarizing now. Mm. I want to plead that those sons and daughters at home, let's get ready. Get your PVC and get ready to vote. Don't sit at home. Don't be intimidated. You vote, like I always say, we will protect our vote. And then we enjoy the dividends of this administration for another 4 years.
Yes. Yes. All our stress and
yeah, we'll be foregone. And for those of us who are in diaspora, those who are in other parts of Nigeria, we need to solicit, talk to our people, talk to your family,
yes,
talk to our friends, let them go and vote.
Exactly. So that at the end, victory will be for us. We have
absolutely.
We have a cause to celebrate the victory of Governor Obaseki.
Most of us speaking out now. We are not politicians, but we have seen that work is going on. Mm. And they always say, because I follow football a lot, and they always say that you don't change a winning team. That's why you see coaches of all these top clubs when they are on a winning streak, they don't change the team. They just keep on. Except the player gets injured, they will not replace the player. You just keep playing on. So the work is very visible. So let's get on and take our state to our expected El Dorado, like they say.
El Dorado. Oh, I love that.
Thank you, Nekwe.
You know, they said that those state is the home of intellectuals. You have Honorable Obayagbola, Patrick Obayagbo, who always speak the English inside the aqua.
He's in another grammatical word, yes.
Yeah.
So, yes, Nekwe, I forgot something. This one is another very vital point. Please, if I can get some time to mention this.
Of course, go ahead.
Yeah, the CDA issue.
Oh yeah, I've discussed it so many times. I approach it from the perspective of the monarch. I also approach it from the governor Obaseki side as well. I did that so many times. Go ahead.
Yes, this is a personal experience. I was doing a project in Benin. I paid and paid from my nose. Because multiple payments. When you are doing foundation, you pay. When they see that you are at a lintel level, you pay. When you want to do roofing, you pay. You are painting, you pay. So this was going on. People want to establish a small company.
Mm.
The CDA, they will come and they'll be collecting money.
You can even buy your own land how many times?
So what happened? When our Oba, God bless our Oba, Omonoba Nedo, Oba Ewaye the second, Ogidiga. The Oba said no, and the governor also picked it up. The Oba backing up as well, and the governor sent sent a bill to the State House of Assembly, and then they pass into law, and they criminalize CDA activities. Are we not all enjoying peace now?
Because it's not a state law.
Yes, it's an offense.
Yes.
To extort money from innocent citizens who want to like build their house. Mm-hmm. A lot of those ones, they started building houses in Lagos and and then in another place, because you come, you spend a lot of money before you even put one block down. Nobody have time for that. They started, people just started building house and buying estates in Lagos and all that.
If you want to renovate your house, build house, you want to renovate, they will ask you for money.
Yes.
If you want to mud block, they will ask you for money.
So the place was turning to like a jungle, and you were like, what is going on here? Excuse me? So, but now you see, things are refined.
CCFO.
Yeah.
CCFO was reduced to only 50,000 naira.
Exactly.
Governor Obaseki, we will live to remember this man, the history of
Edo. God bless Governor Obaseki for all he's doing and for all he will do. When I start talking about this governor's matter, but my energy just start buzzing.
Exactly.
It's very
transparent. And is anybody who doubts what we are saying, go to Edo State. This is not a propaganda. I'm going to play this one as well. Thank you, Dr. Tony Osakpoma Agbons, all the way from the UK. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. So it is time for us to play the actual video. Guys, if you are watching right now, I'm going to play the video. Okay. That documented some of the developments Governor Obaseki's administration has created for the 3 years, because this video was produced last year, let's just say 3 years. So what he did after that is not included in this video, just say what he did before last year, December. Okay, so I'm going to play the video. Okay, so thank you, Dr. Tony, then I will see you. If you have anything for the audience who are watching, you can go ahead and say that before we end the show.
Nothing really. I think I've said quite a lot. Let me go and enjoy my... It's summer here now. Let me go and enjoy my Sunday. You can see the way I'm dressed. So
yes,
let me go and catch some fun.
Fancy Edoma. Thank you. I would like to also commend your hard work, being an educated, you know, a dope man. I'm proud of you.
Thank
continue
you.
To make us proud in diaspora and in Nigeria. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nekman. Bye.
Yes, bye-bye.
2 strategies towards developing a modern and progressive Edo State, where every citizen is empowered with the opportunity to live life to the fullest. These are stimulated economic, social and infrastructural activities in the state and set it on the path of increasing stability, growth and prosperity. The Gordon Obaseki-led government has been committed in its effort to building governance capacity, strengthening public institutions, promoting fiscal management, ensuring security of lives and property of citizens, reforming the civil service and encouraging public participation. The civil service will have a more positive work environment that enhances productivity and boosts workers' morale with the construction of the Edo State Secretariat Complex, Block C, Block D, and the Treasury House. He tells me of how the place has been abandoned since the time of Samuel Ogbemudia and became a dwelling place for criminals and drug addicts. But now, it has been transformed to a modern world-class edifice. In the same way, the Edo State government constructed and donated an industrial court complex to National Industrial Court of Nigeria, the second state in Nigeria after Rivers State to achieve this feat. Other projects undertaken by the government include the Judges' Quarters, the new High Court building, the Edo State Traffic Management New Office, the Edo State Development Property Authority, the Observer Newspaper, the Edo State GIS, the Edo House Abuja, and many more. Surprisingly, all those complaints about inefficiency and poor management of the state financial resources have come to an end. The government put in place measures that have ensured better transparency and accountability in the use of our resources. I recall that only a few years ago, the Edo State Task Administration was a mess, with the process mostly controlled by towns. Now, the process has been automated by improving transparency, efficiency and compliance, This has resulted in increase in the IGR of the state, which allows the government to do more for the people. This is the new and revamped ETSMA, born out of the government desire to ensure proper direction, control and supervision of all vehicular and pedestrian traffic, made up of trained men and women who are more civil, better equipped and operate within the ambit of the law. The government also considers the security of lives and property of citizens as matter of paramount importance. The Edo Safe City project was introduced to train some of the top police officers in the state on modern combat techniques. And a new security architecture for the state was launched in 2018, tagged Operation White Baizigan, with state-of-the-art security information management system to combat crime using modern techniques and methods. This is because we all know that without security, investors are more likely to be discouraged from investing in Edo State. Edo State under Governor Godwin Obaseki, in view of improving economic prosperity, has implemented various programs to balance the current and future needs of citizens. The question he asked, however, was, can any meaningful development happen in a state without regular power supply?
And my people, the people of Edo State, know that this exists. So they know that there's power here. So how do I explain to them why they're in darkness? So whatever it will take to give my people power, we must do. And whoever we feel is a stumbling block, we must get rid of.
I remember watching that on the evening news some time ago. And guess what? All that will soon be a thing of the past. First, Edo State enabled the development of an independent power plant known as the Azura Edo Power Plant, with a capacity of 461 megawatts, and also the setting up development of the 55 megawatt Osiomo Power Plant, which is now completed. Here are efforts to provide more electricity for distribution within the state, with plans to distribute power generated by the plant to production centers in the state. To ensure regular supply of fertilizer to farmers for more productive agribusiness, the Edo Fertilizer and Chemical Company has been revamped. The 60,000 metric ton capacity plant was revived through a public-private venture about 14 years after it was abandoned. The state is currently promoting community-based on-farm and off-farm management along key agricultural value chains like maize, cassava, oil palm, soybeans and rice. The Agripreneur program has over 1,880 farmers on over 5,800 hectares of land. The state is cultivating rice in Igoriaki, Ogwomo, Warake, Agenebode and Ilushi, and cultivating maize at Usugbenu and Sobe, and soybeans at Ekwoma. 150 hectares of land is earmarked for oil palm production across four local government areas, involving oil palm estate investors and also community smallholder farmers. The government believes that through agriculture, we can improve the standard of living and create the much needed wealth in communities.
But this Warake bush, the soil is very nice. And if you plant something like this, no, it is not grown up. See many corn and everything where cassava, everything where people plant for here now. Now so everybody they enjoy that. But we know they see money, we know they see more where they take help us, where they help us. Try to load there and look at our plant, no help us. So we come surprised this year now, this thing don't happen now. The thing called the fast for our hand. This sand now here they don't see as they can't till all this one and cataplant work for all these places for us. So all these places now. We come to get happiness and thank God, say, may God bless these people where they say they want to help the poor farmer on this time around.
Well, I guess I'll miss having stimulating conversation with Mr. Osarobo. Because soon, we will be moving to our own home. Have you heard of Emoton Gardens? It's a state government-backed 1,800-unit housing project, providing affordable housing for its citizens. It features 2 and 3 bedroom flats, villas, bungalows and terrace homes. And the best part is that we can pay in installments. It is now common for residents to wake up and see the sight of graders and tractors working on either major roads or streets in Edo State. Substantial road projects have been completed across the 18 local government councils in the state. Others are in progress. Many more have been awarded. And this has also improved road transportation in some areas and also encouraged transportation network companies like Uber and Bolt Taxify to launch businesses in Edo State. This has provided competitive pricing for transportation and created jobs within the state.
Our keke safe, they're very safe because we know the 2 they repair keke like before. Before, if you ride keke 3 days, 4 days, you must visit mechanic. You must go see mechanic. But now, you can ride 1 month, nothing they happen.
Like my street now, where I did now, no expense, nobody go touch this area before. But I'm surprised to see. That's why the name they give our governor, we can see. In fact, he qualify.
Making drinking water available to every citizen is one of government's priority. The rehabilitation of Ugboha Water Scheme to provide potable water to over 500,000 industrial and domestic consumers in Edo Central is underway. Other water projects are ongoing at Igwobazua and Udo in Ovia Southwest Local Government Area and Ofunwebe in Ovia Northeast and four other local government